个奉献人哈，叫我呢讲述呢，可贝勒在对他的母亲这个后体的教导哈，在网上愿意提供一篇章。
Just a very very brief history. Kapila Dev is the son of Devahuti and Cardinal Muni. Cardinal Muni is the son of Brahmaji, who ordered him and his other sons to procreate the universe with good Krishna conscious children.
那么呢，简单的讲一下历史哈。主 Kapila Dev 的话呢，是呢 Devahuti 及呢Cardinal Muni。他的母女的哈这个儿子，那么他的母女的话呢是呢哈 Brahmaji 的这个儿子的，那么当时呢他受 Brahmaji 的受命传好道呢，就是说呢养育哈生育后代的。
Cardinal Muni let's worship the Lord to get a good wife for such procreation, and the Lord appeared to him and said, not only will I give you a good devoted wife, but I will also come as your son.
那么呢当时呢哈他呢就崇拜主了。祈祷呢哈，能得到一个呢，一个好的妻子哈。那么当时呢，主呢就向他显现，他说不仅我要给你一个奉献者妻子，而且呢，我也亲自呢前来成为你的儿子。
When Kapila Dev appeared from the womb of Devahuti, Cardinal Muni at that time worshipped the Lord and begged him that I want to now take sannyas.Let me always meditate on you within my heart.
那么当可比拉戒佛即将从娘胎里面哈出来的时候呢，那么他的父亲呢，他的妈母女的话呢哈，就向神哈祈祷了。他说呢，我现在哈想接受生命的气体阶段哈，三亚啊这个信号啊，许我这个愿望。
Lord Kapila Dev granted him that benediction, and then when Cardinal Muni took sannyas to Rome and become absorbed in the Lord.More absorbed in the Lord. Lord Kapila Dev went back to the palace of Devahuti, which was created by the mystic powers of her husband, and began to teach her.
那么当时的话呢，因为呢主的这个祝福了，那么 Kapila Dev 就 Kapila Dev 哈就祝福他的这个就他的父亲呢就离开了哈 ，Kama Dev Kama Muni 就离开了，所买的这些就是周游世界哈去呢就是说。离开了哈，下去生活。那么他现在这一次呢，回到了他的宫殿。那么这个宫殿是由他的父亲呢，他的妈母女的话呢，用的是神通哈，创造了一个呢，宫殿。
Kapila Dev, the incarnation of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Krishna, sat with his mother in the palace, and she began to inquire from him.
那么当时呢，他这个 days 哈，作为主的一个呢，真主呢 ，Krishna 的一个化身，在呢这个宫殿里面向他的母亲哦，就是讲授。那么他母亲呢，这个父亲哦，提出了很多的问题。
I no longer want to be disturbed by my raging senses and mind. How can I become free from all this?
他就问了哈，我不想再受到我哈那个心意和呢这个感官哈这个冲动哈这个影响。那我应该怎么样做？
How can I become free from the darkness of ignorance? What process is there?
怎么免除呢？哈，愚昧黑暗，这个程序怎么走
？So Kapila Dev began to explain. Now I will discuss with you that particular type of yoga practice.
那么 Kapila Dev 就说了哈，现在我跟你讨论的哈，一种特别类型的哈，这个呢 ，yoga 哈瑜伽的程序。
To become free by all material, free from all material happiness and distress.The modes of nature, the bodily conception of life, the false ego.
他说：“你将免除呢所有的痛苦和快乐哈，只要我以及呢不是自然的这个捆绑等等。”
And he explained a very, very important verse, which Srila Gurudev quotes all the time.
那么他引述了哈一个呢，就是一个师姐了。那么这也是 Gurudev 哈经常来引用的一个师姐。
He told his mother that she should.Remain in the association of pure devotees.
那么首先的话呢，他告诉他的母亲哦，永远停留在呢这个呢奉献者的这个联谊之中。
And in such association, she should hear the glories of the Lord.
那么在这种联谊之中呢，去聆听主的荣耀。
Sambho sangam mama jiyo sangido pavanti kukamarasa yanasapa.Ashashanasa Prabhagavatmani Shadaradhi Bhakti Ranukramishati One should remain in the association of pure devotees and should hear from them about the pastimes and activities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
一个人应该停留在纯粹奉献者的联系中，从他那里去聆听至尊主的逍遥时光活动。
Such harikatha is pleasing both to the ear and to the heart.
那么这种的哈利卡塔的话呢，不仅对于耳朵哈来说呢是悦耳的，也是呢哈愉悦呢这个就是说呢心的，就是心里的。
Simply by hearing and such association.One becomes free from all anarthas, all unwanted things, and habits, and thoughts.
那么在这种聆听中的话，一个人都能免除一哈这些呢要不得的哈这些呢欲望恶习啊等等。
And under the guidance of such pure devotee, they progress through the stages of bhakti from shraddha to bhava to shraddha to nistha to ruchi, gradually to ashakti, then to bhava, then to prema.
那么在这种呢奉献者的指导下，一个人呢逐渐的走过了哈这个修习的这个各阶段，从十二法开始，信息开始，有意识哈稳固的修习，到阿萨提阿鲁提阿萨提巴啊对等等。
The Kapila Dev explains the qualities of such a sadhu.
那么 Kapila Dev 呢描述了哈这样一位沙鲁圣人，他的品质应该是怎样子的
？He's friendly to everyone. He's tolerant.He's merciful, he's equal to everyone, he has no material desires, he's peaceful.
那么这样一位圣人的话呢，他对所有众生都是友善的，他很容忍，他非常仁慈，他对众生平等，等等。
He explains that there is many different kinds of devotional service also. Devotional service in the mode of ignorance, devotional service in the mode of passion, devotional service in the mode of goodness, and also,unadulterated pure devotional service.
那么他也解释了哈，奉献服务呢有不同层面的，那么有呢愚昧形态的奉献服务，有激情形态的奉献服务，也有善良形态的，也有哈纯粹的奉献服务。
Devotional service which is mixed with material desires of envy and revenge and anger, such service is called karma mishrabhakti.And that is in the mode of ignorance.
那么如果呢奉献服务里面呢混杂有呢哈这个呢嫉妒啊嗔恨啊等等这些情绪的话呢，它属于哈愚昧形态的这个呢奉献服务。
When it's performed with a desire for opulence, material happiness, then it's in the mode of passion.
如果呢他呢执行奉献服务呢想得到富裕哈，想得到这些那么它属于呢这个呢。
And when it's performed free from any material desire, then it's in the mode of pure goodness.
如果它没有任何的哈这个物质欲望混杂其中的话呢，就是呢哈纯粹的这个善良心哈。
To be free from the desire to be free from frivolous actions for my own happiness, that's in the mode of material goodness. So the desire just to rush to the Lord is unadulterated bhakti.
他们呢，只是要想免除哈，就是说没有的自然的自己的私欲哈，这种的奉献服务的话呢，它属于善良形态啊，这个奉献服务。但是如果一切的话都是呢以主为核心的哈，一切都是奔向他的，那么属于呢哈善，就是纯粹的这个奉献服务。
To explain that the manifestation of unadulterated pure devotional service is that as soon as one hears the glories of the Lord, his mind immediately rushes to the Lord.
那么这已经讲到了哈，具有呢纯粹奉献服务哈这种情感的人的话呢，他只要哈聆听到主的信息的话呢哈，他的心立即哈就走向他。
In such devotional ecstasy, he is compared with the Ganges river that rushes towards the sea without any impediment.
那么这一类型的奉献服务呢，被誉为哈像恒河之水呢哈奔向大海一样啊。
The Lord also explained to her about meditation on the form of the Lord.
那么他在这次话也向他母亲讲说如何去冥想主哈。
He discussed in great detail the lotus feet of the Lord, the hips of the Lord, the waist, the beautiful lotus eyes.
那么他呢很详细的描述了哈，至尊主的莲花足啊哈，他的这个哈臀部，就腰部哈，以及他的上身哈、腿部等等这些特征。
And so that this should be the only object of meditation.
并且指出了哈，冥想至尊主的话，至尊主作为哈。唯一的冥想对象。
One should associate with a pure devotee who is always absorbed in this meditation.
那么一个人应该哈以
Mozilla is absorbed in tasting the pastimes of the Lord and the various forms of the Lord. And thus they have no desire, even for going to the heavenly planet. They're not at all interested in the eightfold mystic opulences. What a speak of attachment to home, to family, to domestic animals, to wealth. They have absolutely no interest. And this is the type of devotee that the Srila Dev is telling his mother to associate with.
那么这种人的话，对他的家庭哈，他的这个哈，这个家里面的哈，这珍珠哈，这些东西的话呢，就更没有了哈，依附了。所以呢，这是呢，卡佩拉，是呢，卡佩拉盖哈，向他的母亲这个乌迪哈所讲述的这种奉献服务。
Suppose that anyone who is so absorbed, he attains a transcendental opulence that can never be taken away by time.
那么这样的一个专注其中的这样一个人的话哈，他们得到的这个东西是永远不会呢被拿走的。
That can never be destroyed by any weapon.
也永远不会被哈任何武器的哈所伤。
But he's always fixed, just as Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, when one attains this stage of samadhi, he thinks there's nothing, no greater gain, and has never shaken even in the midst of the greatest difficulty.
那么达到这种三摩地状态的人的话哈，就算他遭遇到巨大的困难的话，也不会动摇的哈。就算面临巨大的这个困难的话呢，也没有呢动摇。
Lord Kapila Dev explained to her that there's no use in looking in any other direction than the Lord. Because actually there's no existence outside of him. He explained how the Lord glances over the material nature, and the material nature is created from him, from his own energy.
描述到了哈，主呢通过他的解释了创造这个物质宇宙，那么就是说呢，一切来源于他的物质能量哈。
Then by the glance of the Lord, in the course of time, which is also his energy,